I consider sexual assault as a disease in our society, which needs an immediate cure. So imagine a scenario where a person is intoxicated or not in a condition to respond, or in cases of college campus assault or date rape, a victim is unable to even stand up for themselves, and we want to cater to those kind of situations. We're creating a project to detect, communicate, and prevent sexual assault in real time. There are two ways in which the technology works. One of them is active and the second is passive. In case of passive, we assume that the victim is conscious and can actuate the button by themselves. In an active system, we receive the information from the external environment. If somebody is trying to remove the clothing off the person's body, we first send a message to confirm if the act was done with consent or not. And the wearer gets 30 seconds to answer this. And if they do not answer within that time span, it starts buzzing a loud noise. And that is like an alert for the wearer. Once you do not even respond in those 20 seconds, it starts broadcasting your information to people who are in your predefined safety circle. So the safety circle receives information about the geolocation of the victim. And also one member of that group receives a phone call, and that call records all the noises, any kind of conversation which is happening, and you can use this information for legal proceedings. It clips onto any kind of clothing because it is an adhesive material, so we're using hydrogel as an addition. So the best part about hydrogel is that it doesn't leave any residues behind. It can be washed, so all you need to do is just take out that electronic part of it, and it's like a clip-on, so it's like you just stick it like a sticker on any kind of your clothing, and you can put it anywhere, from your panties to bra to shirts, pants, anywhere. So the first layer is the conductive layer, which is trying to detect the stretch and the forceful removal of clothing. And the second layer we have is the non-conductive layer, and it prevents from any short circuit. And below that we have a small thin patch, which is conductive again. So it's basically conductive, non-conductive, conductive, and the hydrogel, which is non-conductive and also adhesive in nature. I come from India. I was trained as an automobile engineer back in India in southern part. And that's why I left home. But unfortunately, I became a liability to the institution because women, especially female students on campus, were not allowed to work beyond certain hours. As a first-year student, you were expected to be in your dorm around 6:30. In the name of safety, many times women have been told to stop working or asked to be indoors. And I think instead of asking them to be indoors, we should have more safety for them. We don't need bodyguards. I think I should have the ability to protect myself and should be able to be standing alone for myself. And that's what I would want this product to do.